Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing fine and are taking care of yourselves. My name is Kanika Tandon and I'm here with the video of class 6th English 2nd. In our today's video, we are going to read the chapter 4, which is The Miracle. Chapter number 4, The Miracle. So this chapter is, this is a story about a little 11-year-old boy, Charlie. Alright, so Charlie and the Chocolate Factory is about an 11-year-old boy named Charlie Bucket, who lives in a small house with his parents and four grandparents. Willy Wonka, a rather strange chocolatier, has hidden 5 golden tickets in the chocolate bars. Those who find the tickets win a visit to the Chocolate Factory and get a lifelong supply of the chocolates. 4 tickets have been found. Now let's read what happens when Charlie tries for the last ticket with a few coins that he has. So the story is about a little boy who's 11 years old and his name is Charlie. The story revolves how Willy Wonka, a very popular chocolatier, has a factory and has constructed a competition kind of a thing in which the people have to find 5 golden tickets that are somewhere hidden in the chocolates, and 4 are already found, and the one who finds the 5th one will get to visit the chocolate factory and will get a lifelong supply of the chocolates. So let's see what happens in the story. Charlie entered the shop and laid the damn 50 pence on the counter. "One Wonka's Whipple Scrumptious Fudge Mellow Delight," he said, remembering how much he had loved that one he had on his birthday. The man behind the corner looked fat and well-fed. He had big lips and fat cheeks and a very fat neck. The fat around his neck bulged out all around the top of his collar like a rubber ring. He turned and reached behind him for the chocolate bar, and then he turned back again and handed it to Charlie. So he enters, this Charlie boy enters in the shop and asks for his favorite Wonka's Whipple Scrumptious Fudge Mellow Delight. And in the next paragraph, they are explaining how fat the shopkeeper was. Charlie grabbed it quickly, tore off the wrapper, and took an enormous bite. Then he looked another, and then he took another and another, and oh, the joy of being able to charm large pieces of something sweet and solid into one's mouth. The sheer blissful joy of being able to fill one's mouth with rich solid food. Okay, so since Charlie liked this chocolate a lot, he unstoppingly started to eat a he started to take big bites of the chocolate without seeing anything that is happening around. He is just enjoying the chocolate in his mouth. "You look like you wanted that one, Sonny," the shopkeeper said pleasantly. Charlie nodded, his mouth bulging with chocolate. The shopkeeper put Charlie's change on the counter. "Take it easy," he said. "It will give you a tummy ache if you swallow it without chewing." So now the shopkeeper also understood that it was Charlie's favorite, and he was literally eating like he has not eaten anything. So the shopkeeper also suggests him that he should stop eating it so abruptly, because it will give him a stomach ache if he eats it without chewing. Charlie went on wolfing down the chocolate. He couldn't stop, and in less than half a minute, the whole thing had disappeared down his throat. He was quite out of breath, but he felt marvelously, extraordinarily happy. He reached out a hand to take the change. Then he paused. His eyes were just above the level of the counter. He was staring at the silver coins lying there. The coins were 5 penny pieces. There were 9 of them altogether. Surely it wouldn't matter if he spent just 1 own. So what happened? Since he was eating down the chocolate like he has not eaten anything, he finished the whole chocolate in half less than half a minute, and he was extraordinarily happy about it. When he saw the change kept on the counter that the shopkeeper gave him back, he felt very happy and thought that it won't be a bad thing if he would spend another money on the chocolate and have one more. I think, he said quietly, I will have just one more of these chocolate bars, the same kind as before, please. Why not? The fat shopkeeper said, reaching behind him again and taking another Whipple scrumptious fudge mellow delight from the shelf. He laid it on the counter. Charlie picked it up, tore off the wrapper, and suddenly underneath the wrapper there came a brilliant flash of gold. Charlie's heart stood still. What happened? He bought one more of the chocolate from the shopkeeper, and the shopkeeper put the chocolate on the counter. And what happened? As soon as he opened the packet, he saw a golden ticket, and Charlie's heart was still. He could not see or speak anything. "It's a golden ticket," screamed the shopkeeper, leaping about a foot in the air. "You've got a golden ticket. You've found the last golden ticket. Hey, won't you believe it? Come on and come look at this, everybody. The kids found Wonka's last golden ticket. There it is. It is right in his hand." And since he is also happy to see that the kid has found a golden ticket, he is screaming and calling everybody to look at the golden ticket. It seemed as though the shopkeeper would collapse in the fit. "In my shop too," he yelled. "He found it right here in my own little shop. Somebody call the newspaper quick and let them know. Watch out, New Sonny. Don't tear as you unwrap it. That thing is precious." So now he is happy that the boy has found the golden ticket in his little shop, and he wanted the media to come and cover it. In few seconds, there was a crowd of about 20 people clustering around Charlie, and many more were pushing their way in from the street. Everybody wanted to get a look of the golden ticket and luckier and the lucky finder. "Where it is?" somebody shouted. "Hold it up so all of us can see it." "There it is, there," someone else shouted. "He's holding it in his hand. See the golden shining." So everybody is very eager to see the finder who found the golden ticket and also the golden ticket itself. "How did he manage to find it? I would like to know," a large boy shouted angrily. 20 bars a day. I have been buying them for weeks and weeks. And now everybody is bringing out their anger that they have been buying so many of chocolate, but they did not get any of the tickets. "Think of all the free stuff he'll be getting too," another boy said enviously. In a jealous way they said it. "A lifetime supply. He needed the skinny little shrimp," a girl said, laughing. Charlie hadn't moved. He hadn't even unwrapped the golden ticket from around the chocolate bar. He was standing very still, holding it tightly with both his hands, while the crowd pushed and shouted all around him. He felt quite dizzy. There was a peculiar floating sensation coming over him, as though he were floating up in the air like a balloon. His feet didn't seem to be touching the ground at all. He could hear his heart thumping away loudly somewhere in his throat. So he was holding the ticket very tightly because he was scared that since all the people were coming around from him, somebody could snatch it. And he was feeling a little dizzy also. He was feeling a little sick because everybody was gathered around him, and he was feeling very strange because everybody was looking at him. At that point, he became aware of the hand resting lightly on his shoulder, and when he looked up, he saw a tall man standing over him. "Listen," the man whispered, "I buy it from you. I will give you 50 pounds. How about it, huh? And I'll give you a new bicycle as well." So now people have started to come and try and are trying to buy things from the, buy this golden ticket from the little boy. Somebody is offering him a bicycle and 50 pounds. Somebody is offering another thing. Let us read what everybody else has to offer. "That's quite enough of that," the fat shopkeeper shouted, pushing his way through the crowd and taking Charlie firmly by the arm. "Leave the kid alone, will you? Make way there. Let him out." And to Charlie, as he led him to the door, he whispered, "Don't you let anybody have it. Take it straight home quickly before you lose it. Run all the way and don't stop till you get there. You understand?" Charlie nodded. So now what happened? when he saw that everybody was coming and gathering around him and was trying to buy the ticket since he was a kid, the shopkeeper got very angry. And what did he do? He came out of the shop and he came out of the crowd and told Charlie to go out from here and run till he gets home and give it to his mother and father only, because he did not want that Charlie would lose the golden ticket. You know something, the fat shopkeeper said, pausing a moment and smiling at Charlie. Having a feeling you needed some luck, I'm glad you got it. Good luck to you, Sonny. Thank you, Charlie said, and off he went, running through the snow as fast as his legs could. As he fast flew past Mr. Willy Wonka's factory, he turned and waved it and sang, I'll be seeing you, I'll be seeing you. And 5 minutes later, he arrived at his home, own home. And so what happened? The shopkeeper, since he was a kind man, he was very happy that the little boy had got the golden ticket. And he said thank you to the shopkeeper and ran towards his home. In the way, he saw Mr. Willy Wonka's chocolate factory and he said that he'll be seeing Willy Wonka very soon. And then after 5 minutes, he arrived at his home. So this was the chapter. It was an extract adapted from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. This is a very long story, but they have selected some little part only. So this was all. I hope that you all have understood the chapter. I will see you all in my next video with the question answers and the exercise of this chapter. Till then, thank you. Take care.